Morning.
So this Israeli study sounds very exciting. The Pfizer vaccine, very effective, but you know, people can't get the vaccine, let alone distinguish between, oh, I'd rather have Pfizer instead of Moderna.
Well, I think it's really the important thing is that they got a vaccine, a potent vaccine. There's probably very little difference between the efficacy of Moderna and Pfizer. What this study points out, though, is not only do these vaccines prevent new infection, but if you happen to get infected, they save your life. Mm. It's critical. No one in that study that had the two vaccines had died, and only four had serious illness. It's really incredible.
But as we get the variant, whether it's the UK, the South African variant, is this just a blip in the game, or is this a whole new game?
It might be a whole new game, Larry, hate to tell you. But there's all different kinds of variants out there. So the British one, it looks like the vaccine still works pretty well. That's the B117. The South African one, it's not going to work as well. Let's hope it gives some kind of protection. Right now, the vaccine companies are retooling the vaccine so that it works against these nasty variants.
What about out of Oregon? We heard there were four people that had both doses of the vaccine, and then they still tested positive for COVID.
Yeah, no, this is an important point, Robin, because, you know, the vaccines are not 100%. Now, those four people, you know, do we know what happened to them clinically? They got COVID, but I don't think they died from COVID, you know, so it may be that they're partially protected. But it could be the variant. They're sequencing those viruses now. Could just be a regular failure. This is the way it goes. Nothing's 100%.
All right, let's get to viewer questions. I'm hearing that these vaccines are only lasting 3 months or so. Does this mean that we'll have to do this all over again in the fall?
Well, this is not true about just 3 months. Now, the way they're reporting the data, comes in chunks, and so they might have 3 months of data. Looks like it works that far, but there's been people that were vaccinated in the clinical studies way back in the summer, and many of those are still protected. So it's not really true about 3 months. We just don't know how long. It could be 8 months, 9 months, maybe it's going to be a whole year. But the second part of that question is true. You're going to need a booster at some point.
All right, next question. A week after receiving my first Moderna vaccine, I had a red, raised, itchy 2-inch diameter hive at the injection site. It lasted several days. Is it safe to have my second dose? Does this mean I'm allergic to a vaccine component?
Well, the bad reactions to these vaccines are what they are systemic. You know, you go into shock and stuff. To have these local site reactions where you have the injection is not uncommon. Let's put it that way. I hate to use a double negative, but I think this person should have the second dose. It's worth it. I think you just tell the operator, the person administering the vaccine, that you had a bad reaction there, and they can make a decision. But I think it's safe to take it.
All right, next question. I'm scheduled to have my gallbladder removed in just over a week. Is it safe to get my first vaccine before, or should I wait until I'm healed from surgery?
This question brings up a very good point. It's better to take it before. Well, probably about a week before is good, because you want to have the vaccine, see if you have any side effects, a fever or anything like that. Let that go away. As long as you're feeling well at the time of the surgery, that's fine. It's better to do it before than after, because you're going to have to wait until you've completely healed for at least 2 weeks. So better to do it before. Plus, you'll get some protection.
Before we let you go, we are hearing average new cases fell below 100,000 for the first time in months. Is that good news? Does that mean we've turned a corner, or are we just waiting for these variants to kick in?
No, it's very good news, Robin, because it's like two trains going down parallel tracks. You know, we've got the vaccines, we've got people mitigating better and everything, and then you've got the variants popping up. You know, it's this race. And look at the Israeli data. We could be like that too. Now, they vaccinated more people, percentage population, than any other country in the world. So, you know, they got a little bit ahead of us. But, you know, you're going to see in the next couple months, these vaccines, there's going to be availability for everybody. And it's not too far away. So that's the game we're playing.
All right.
Yeah.
Good news.